Okay, here we are at North Orbit Acoustic Lab in St. Paul. I want to go over what goes into a sound test. Now, this sound test that we're doing for the purpose of our products is a little bit different. We're going to go ahead and sound test the way you actually would build in the field. We're going to start off with slotted track. We want to test this exactly how it's done in the field. We're going to go ahead and put R13 in this test. You can see it with and without. And we're using our studs at 24 inches on center. What we'll also be doing is a comparison though between acoustic sealant and some of our fire rated products. STC values are really important, especially now in residential construction. The STC rating is a sound rating, sound transmission rating of the sound that is gonna go through the wall. What they're gonna do in this laboratory here is they'll have the noise on one side and they'll record how much noise passes through the other side. And with that, you'll get an STC rating of how much sound could pass through. For the purpose of this test here, we're gonna go ahead and do acoustic sealant versus the fire rated products. So as you can see right now, they're installing the sealant all the way around. They're gonna leave about a half inch joint on all four sides, seal it all up, and then we'll test it. Now it's gonna be a little bit different because we're gonna test it while it's wet. We wouldn't be able to wait the 3 weeks for it to fully cure, so we will be testing in the wet state, which will give it the best possible number that you could get. As you know, over time, sealant will shrink out, harden, possibly separate, but we're gonna test this at the best possible condition that you will ever have it in, and we'll see how the performance is between the preformed products and wet acoustic sealant. Okay, so for this one here, we're gonna use Hotrod XL at the head of the wall. Now you notice that this profile is very flexible. You can press it all the way down. That's gonna remain flexible for the life of the assembly. This white leg, paintable, it's gonna just kiss or curl over the top of, up to the ceiling, and then it's gonna allow deflection. It's gonna happen during the course of the wall loads up and down, and it'll bounce right back. All right, so this gets up to 3/4 inch movement. We've already placed it up on the top of the wall. Again, it's pink so the inspector could see it. On the verticals, we went a different direction. Verticals, we're going with fire bead. This is the 1 hour profile. You'll notice it's 5/8 back. Flexible leg out here to kiss touch up against the framing member. Got a flexible apex bubble gasket on here. And it's really good for vertical, going up against vertical walls, and that's how we're gonna use it here. We're using hot mud on here just to get it sealed up in time for our test. The big difference between acoustical caulk and these type of products, this remains flexible. Anybody who knows about sound testing and STCs, you know you wanna maintain a flexible perimeter gap. It's very important. The way we test this today, the condition of these profiles, the flexibility of these profiles, they'll remain the same 10 years down the road.